because that's what we're conditioned to do. So I discovered that my body is on my side, and that my body has only ever been good to me and tried to, literally carried me everywhere I've gone my entire life. And like, you know, gives me feelings when I know, when I need to know that something is bad or I need to change something. So I've started to really appreciate my body in the last couple years, and so I wrote her song. The song is called She. Relationship with their baby the trauma that they had with them. So no matter how much they tried, they weren't perfect, so they couldn't love me all. But the thing that seemed super profound to me when I had this realization was like this overwhelming understanding deeply in my soul that the problem wasn't that I was unlovable. The problem was the capability of giving love of the other people. So I sat there in my living room like 100 times. I am. And that was a word. I mean, it's pretty great. Thank you, Killian. But also, I need to remember how to be transposed on this one. Okay, I'm remembering. I got it. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
She experienced depression, she experienced anxiety, she had a really rough time. I mean, COVID happened in her sophomore year, so, you know. So this summer after she graduated, we decided to take a girls' trip. We went to Isla Mujeres, the Isle of Women in Mexico, and it seemed pretty fitting. And we had this hotel room with a balcony, and it overlooked across the street. We could see, like, this bar kind of place. It was kind of like an indoor bar with, like, no walls, but it had, like, swings instead of bar stools, and we're definitely going there. So we went there. It was so much fun. I mean, have you ever been to a bar with swings?
Yes.
Because they're great, right? Like, why don't all bars have swings?
It was
great. So then, we're having this fun, like, bonding time. Like, she's an adult now. And then, they start karaoke. And I was like, what? Like, how could this not get any better? So I decided to sing, it's kind of my go-to karaoke song, it's Somebody to Love by Queen. I don't know if you know that song. Has that part in there where it goes, can anybody find me? Right? Sing it with me. Somebody to love. As you have probably observed, normally while I'm performing, I'm like pretty chill. I don't move around a lot, but that night in Mexico, because I didn't know anybody, I was like all over the stage. I was like a full-on rock star. It was super fun. And everyone was cheering, and we got to that one part with that like high part, and I just happened to look over at my daughter, Madeline, and she was just like glowing. Like she just had this beauty and goodness just sort of like oozing out of her, and like that moment is like forever crystallized in my mind. Like, that was my favorite part of the whole night. That's my favorite part of, like, the whole trip. And it makes me cry to think about it. But I can definitely sing the song without crying. I've done it before. Many times. Anyway. So this song is called The Closest Thing.
Your face, the only one I know. My whole world.
have one more song for you tonight. This one is called Everything. And I wrote it because, you know, do you hear, like, be present, like, be here now, like, be mindful, like, do you hear that all the time? Because I hear that all the time. And every time I hear it, I'm like, right, I remember that. But then it feels like we hear it so much that, at least me, I forget to remember it sometimes. So I wrote a song, actually after having a kind of intense conversation with a friend about death, in an effort to remind me to actually be present. Like, you know, sometimes if you hear things a different way, it can stick. So, this song is called Everything. Thank you.